Our Earth is surrounded by a protective layer, a layer that constantly protects us from the dangers of solar wind. Formed deep within the surface, Earth's magnetic field extends beyond our planet, out into the space. It acts as a shield, protecting both life forms and our modern equipments from the dangers of solar winds. In this video, we are going to focus on Earth's magnetic field and discuss more on what the magnetic poles are, how does it work, changes in poles, and important Earth's magnetic field. And so, let's start with the video. Our planet Earth is surrounded by a powerful magnetic field, or the geomagnetic field, which forms a shield around our planet. This shield is called the magnetosphere. It is generated by our powerful and dynamic forces which are present deep within the center of the Earth. Earth's magnetosphere protects us from erosion of our atmosphere by the solar winds, particle radiation from coronal mass ejection, and cosmic radiation from deep space. It repels most of the unwanted and harmful energy from entering our planet by trapping them in a twin torus or donut-shaped zones called the Van Allen Belt. The magnetosphere is, however, not a perfect shield. Sometimes, charged particles do find its way into our atmosphere, leading to geomagnetic storms, which can impact our power grids. On a positive side, these storms can be a source of a beautiful phenomena called the auroras. In order to understand how Earth's magnetic field works, it is necessary to introduce some key concepts first, starting with the difference between geographic and magnetic poles. The geographic poles are the point where lines of longitude or meridians converge to form geographic north and south pole. The geographic north pole is in the middle of the Arctic Ocean, and the geographic south pole is in the Antarctica. Our Earth can be imagined as one big magnet, as stated by William Gilbert in his work The Magnet. The ends of Earth's magnet lie relatively close to geographic poles at an angle of 11 degrees. Similar to a bar magnet, Earth's magnetic field lines travel in a close, continuous loop and are nearly vertical at each magnetic pole. Magnetic poles are located where the magnetic lines of attraction enter Earth. The magnetic north pole is also known as the North Tip Pole and is currently found on Ellesmere Island in northern Canada. The difference in distance between this magnetic north pole and the geographic north pole is about 500 kilometers. The magnetic north pole is actually South Magnetic Pole, and the magnetic south pole is North Magnetic Pole. This is because the Earth's magnetic field sources are dipolar, meaning they have north and south pole. Also, in magnets, opposite poles attract, while like poles repel each other. In other words, when a compass points north, it is actually attracted to the South Magnetic Pole, which lies close to the geographic North Pole. The source of Earth's magnetic properties is in its core. Earth's core, especially the outer core, is about 2,900 kilometers from the surface, and the inner core is about 5,100 kilometers from the surface. The outer core is liquid, with temperatures ranging from 2,700 degrees Celsius in its outer region to 7,000 degrees Celsius near inner core. It is mainly composed of iron and nickel. The inner core is solid due to high pressure. Temperature on its surface is estimated to be about 5,430 degrees Celsius, which is as hot as the surface of Sun. It is believed to be composed of an iron-nickel alloy along with some other elements. For a planet to generate its own magnetic field, it must have following qualities. It should rotate fast enough. Its interior must have a fluid medium. The interior fluid must have the ability to conduct electricity. The core must have an internal source of energy that propels convection current in the liquid interior. Earth generates its magnetic field in its core, specifically in its outer core. The Earth's outer core is constantly in a state of turbulent convection as a result of radioactive heating and chemical differentiation. Like boiling water on a stove, convection forces constantly churn the molten metals, which also swirl in whirlpools driven by Earth's rotation. As this roiling mass of metal moves around, it generates electrical currents hundreds of kilometers wide and flowing at thousands of kilometers per hour as Earth rotates. This mechanism is known as the geodynamo, a self-sustaining process. At Earth's surface, the magnetic field forms two poles or dipole. The invisible lines of magnetic field travel in a closed, continuous loop, flowing into Earth at the north magnetic pole and out at the south magnetic pole. The solar wind compresses the field's shape on the sun-facing side and stretches it into a long tail on the other side. Earth's magnetic field undergoes changes in its polarity. One of such changes is pole reversal, wherein Earth's magnetic north and south poles swap locations. This results in a weaker magnetic field. With the available paleomagnetic records, including those revealing variations in magnetic field strength, Earth's magnetic poles have reversed 183 times in the last 83 million years, and at least several hundred times in the past 160 million years. The time period between these reversals have varied widely, but the average is about 300,000 years, with last taking place about 780,000 years ago. It is unclear as to what drives pole reversal frequency, but it may be due to convection processes in Earth's mantle. And one thing is definitely sure, that pole reversal does not happen suddenly. Instead, they take place over hundreds to thousands of years. There's another type of change, which are known as excursions, a shorter-lived but significant change to the intensity of the magnetic field that can last from a few centuries to few tens of thousands of years. They happen about 10 times as much as pole reversal. During excursion, magnetic poles can reorient as much as 45 degrees from the previous position and reduce the strength of the field by up to 20%. Excursion events are generally regional rather than global. There have been three significant excursions in the past 70,000 years. The Norwegian Greenland Sea event about 64,500 years ago. The Lachaims event between 42,000 to 41,000 years ago, and the Mono Lake event about 34,500 years ago. A weakened magnetic field due to pole reversal can still protect our planet, as magnetosphere, together with Earth's atmosphere, will prevent cosmic rays and charged solar particles from reaching Earth's surface. Although there may be a small amount of particulate radiation that could still find its way. Other than changes in polarity of Earth's magnetic field, magnetic poles also move. The magnetic north pole was first located to be at Cape Adelaide, Boothia Peninsula, in the year 1831 by a British Royal Navy officer and polar explorer Sir James Clark Ross. Ever since then, magnetic North Pole has drifted in northwest direction by more than 1,100 kilometers, and its forward speed has increased from about 16 kilometers per year to about 55 kilometers per year. According to the latest IGRF data, the pole is currently moving at a slightly reduced speed of about 45 kilometers per year. As of year 2020, magnetic North Pole was located at 80.65 degrees north, 72.68 degrees west on Ellesmere Island, Nunavut, Canada, and the magnetic South Pole was located to be at 80.65 degrees south, 107.32 degrees east. Earth's magnetic field forms a protective bubble, also known as magnetosphere. It protects us from harmful space weather like solar wind. It also protects Earth from large quantities of particle radiation emitted during coronal mass ejections, or CME, events, and also from cosmic radiation raining down on Earth from deep space. Magnetosphere is not a perfect shield. Strong space weather like high solar winds or large CME events can disturb Earth's magnetic field, leading to geomagnetic storms which can cause widespread power outages and endanger astronauts and low Earth orbiting satellites. One such example of geomagnetic storm is the Carrington event that happened in year 1859, causing widespread telegraph system failures. Events like these highlights the importance of Earth's magnetic field. Lastly, various organisms like pigeons make use of magnetoreception for navigation and orientation purpose. To conclude, Earth's magnetic field is very unique in its own way. It forms an invisible cocoon, or the magnetosphere, which is essentially important for survival and navigation. With that being said, what is your opinion on Earth's magnetic field? Feel free to share your thoughts. Until then, see you in the next video.